Yeah, let's see what is hyperconjugation in this video. In my previous videos, I've already discussed about the inductive effect, mesomeric effect and its applications. Now let's see the hyperconjugation here. Before going to what is hyperconjugation, let's see what's the inductive effect in this particular groups here. In tertiary group, tertiary butyl carbocation is more stable than secondary, which is more stable than primary, and then comes methyl in the order. This tertiary butyl group is stable because of the plus I effect of this methyl groups here. There are three methyl groups. So the positive charge on this carbocation is shared by three methyl groups. So this is very stable than secondary, which has only two methyl groups here. And then comes the primary, which has only one methyl group, and then comes the methyl group. But in few cases, when we observe that the order is completely reversed, when these alkyl groups are attached to a unsaturated system or double bonded carbon or sp2 carbon, the order is completely reversed here. Why this is happening here? The methyl is stable, then ethyl, then comes isopropyl, then comes the tertiary butyl. This is because of the effect which is different from the inductive effect which is operating in the unsaturated systems or the systems with the double bonded carbon, which can be explained based on the hyperconjugation. Before going to what is hyperconjugation, let's see what are alpha hydrogens. If we take the example of this toluene here, that is methyl benzene, this CH3 is attached to sp2 carbon, a double bonded carbon. So this carbon is called as alpha carbon, and the hydrogens are called as alpha hydrogens or hyperconjugable hydrogens. And when we see this alkene, it's very clear here, this is sp2 carbon here, and this is alpha carbon. So the carbon which is attached to the double bonded carbon is alpha carbon, and these are the alpha hydrogens. There are three alpha hydrogens here. So these are the hydrogens which are responsible for hyperconjugation. So these hydrogens are called as hyperconjugable hydrogens. If we take the example of the alkyl groups attached to this benzene ring, the order is as follows. So methyl benzene is more stable than ethyl, then comes isopropyl, and then comes tertiary butyl. The following order is seen, which is different from that of an inductive effect here. Let's see this in methyl benzene. If you see that in this methyl benzene, here the carbon is attached to a double bonded carbon or sp2 carbon here. So this is an alpha carbon, and there are three alpha hydrogens here. And this is an alpha hydrogens. So CH3 group is attached. So the number of alpha hydrogens here are three alpha hydrogens, and the number of structures which are possible are four here. We can see this. Four structures which are possible here. One, two, three and four canonical structures or hyperconjugable structures or resonance structures. And in each structure, different hydrogen is participating. In this one, it's this hydrogen which is participating. It is releasing the electrons into the system. As a result, the ring carbon is getting the negative charge here, and the hydrogen is getting the positive charge. And this third structure, the hydrogen, this hydrogen is participating here. As a result, this is getting the positive charge. And in the fourth structure, this hydrogen which is participating here, and as a result, this is getting the positive charge, and four canonical structures are possible. Now, when the ethyl group is attached to a benzene ring or sp2 carbon here, the number of alpha hydrogens, we can see this are only two here. This is the alpha carbon. So these are the alpha hydrogens. So number of alpha hydrogens are two alpha hydrogens, and the number of the hyperconjugation structures which are possible are three here, three canonical structures, and two different hydrogens are getting positive charge in two different two structures here. And as the number of alpha hydrogens are decreasing, the number of hyperconjugation structures are also decreasing. And when isopropyl group is attached to the sp2 carbon or unsaturated system here, the number of alpha hydrogens is only one here. So the number of alpha hydrogens is only one here, this one. So number of structures possible are two structures. And when the tertiary butyl group is attached to the benzene ring, no alpha hydrogens, so no resonance structures which are possible. So from the above example, if we see that as the number of alpha hydrogens are decreasing, the number of hyperconjugation structures are decreasing. Here there are number of alpha hydrogens are three alpha hydrogens, here two alpha hydrogens, here one alpha hydrogen, and here no alpha hydrogens. So as the number of alpha hydrogens decreasing, the stability is decreasing as the number of hyperconjugation structures are decreasing. So yes, so yeah, observation of these above structures, if we see the number canonical structures are decreasing in number, and the electron releasing effect is different from that of what is there in inductive effect, and this is what is hyperconjugation. So let's define what is hyperconjugation now. The hyperconjugation is electronic effect involving sigma electrons and the p orbitals here. If you see here, it is the sigma electrons and the p orbitals which are involved in resonance. So that is what is hyperconjugation. This is also called as Bacon-Athen effect or no bound resonance, which can be explained by means of this orbital overlap. Yeah, if you carefully observe the CH3 attached to the benzene ring here, this is the p orbital on the benzene ring on one of the carbons of this benzene ring, and in the example shown, the CH sigma bond here, and this is the p orbital here. So we can see that the CH sigma bond orbital is present adjacent to that of this p orbital of benzene ring. So the CH sigma bond orbital can overlap with the p orbital of benzene, and resulting in the resonance structure here. This one is something like this, which is seen here, and as a result, the carbon of the benzene ring is getting a negative charge here. Yes, carbon of the benzene ring is getting a negative charge here, and as a result, H plus is formed, and there is no bond in between the CH. There is no bond, hence it is called as no bond resonance, because there is no bond in between C and H. And this these CC bonds are easily Yeah, CC bond rotation is free, so this p orbital can overlap with any of these CH sigma bond orbitals. This can overlap. So as there are number of alpha hydrogens, there will be that many number of resonance structures. So the number of alpha hydrogens is directly proportional to the number of resonance structures. So this p orbital can overlap with any of these CH sigma bond orbitals. Yes. So these are all hypothetical structures and only imaginary, and can easily explain the hyperconjugation effect here. Hyperconjugation effect is more when number of alpha hydrogens are more, and this can be seen even in alkenes. The same effect is operated in alkenes. If we take the propene here, yes, if we take the propene here, there are number of alpha hydrogens are three here. This is alpha carbon because this is next to that of the double bonded seat. So this is alpha carbon, and the number of alpha hydrogens are 3, and 4 canonical forms are possible here, and each hydrogen getting the positive charge in different structures. So different CH sigma bond orbital is overlapping with the p orbital of this sp2 hybridized carbon atom. And in butene here, the number of alpha hydrogens are 2 here. This is an alpha carbon, and the number of alpha hydrogens are 2 here, and the number of canonical forms are 3. 1, 2, and 3 here. These are the resonance structures or hyperconjugable structures which are possible for butene. And when we come to the isopropyl group, which is attached to the unsaturated system here, the number of alpha hydrogens is only 1 here. So number of canonical forms, there are 2. And here there are no alpha hydrogens when tertiary butyl group is attached to the unsaturated system. So no canonical forms here. So there is no resonance which is possible, or hyperconjugation which is possible, when tertiary butyl group is attached to the non-saturated system. So here we can see that the number of canonical forms are decreasing as the number of alpha hydrogens are decreasing. And we can see that this is an Plessy effect, because the alpha hydrogen which is seen here is electron releasing group and is releasing the electrons into the system. So this is an Plessy effect, and the groups are Plessy group, hyperconjugation groups. And the hydrogens here are, which are participating in the hyperconjugation or hyperconjugable hydrogens or alpha hydrogens, and the structure are hyperconjugable structures, and this is Plessy effect. An example we can clearly see for Plessy effect is, Plessy effect is alpha hydrogens here. So the groups which release the electrons through hyperconjugation are known as electron releasing groups, or Plessy, or simply it's a Plessy group. And there's something other than Plessy is also operating, which is opposite to that of Plessy, is minus Hessy, that is minus hyperconjugation. For example, when we take trifluoromethylbenzene, this is an alpha carbon here. In the alpha position, there is a fluorine, which is more electronegative atom. So it attracts electrons from the system, and the effect opposite to that of the hyperconjugation effect is seen, which is nothing but minus Hessy effect, and the groups are minus Hessy group. And the ring carbon is getting the positive charge here. There it was negative charge, here it is positive charge. And fluorine is a minus Hessy group here. Example for minus Hessy is fluorine here. Yes, and there are 4 resonance structures which are possible for trifluoromethylbenzene. Yes, let's see the difference of inductive effect, mesomeric effect, and hyperconjugation effect. The major difference we can see here is, here the sigma electrons are participating in the resonance. Here pi and n electrons are operating in the resonance. And here it is the sigma electrons and p orbitals which are participating in the resonance. And the hyperconjugation is nothing but the extension of the mesomeric effect, and in most cases it is opposite to that of the mesomeric effect.